What happened to you? You disappeared.
Yeah, I think it was probably the best decision that I've made. One of the best decisions I've made in my life.
For Kevin Federline, there's no greater joy than being a dad to his blended brood. Six children. It's a life he insists that he has tried to live far away from the glare of the media spotlight. But 15 years after the end of their marriage, Kevin Federline has some issues to address. And so, he invited celebrity interviewer Daphne Barak into his home to talk about life with Brittany and beyond.
I was mortified for her. I really was, for a long time. Way past the time that people were watching. It's been years. I still feel bad for her. You know, I mean, it's hard. Nobody can prepare you for anything like what I've been through. You know, I mean, nobody. But to me, I had a job to do, and that.
And no one could have foreseen just how much of an icon Brittany would become. In the blink of an eye, she was catapulted to megastardom. Her carefully crafted image shaped by marketing executive Kim Kamen.
It's quite the leap in anyone's book from the Mickey Mouse Club to Hit Me Baby One More Time.
Yeah, it's a leap. I mean, but what people don't know is that there was a lot of work that had been done leading up to that, like the photo shoots that were done, the interviews that were done, the media training, the choreography, the dance, the preparation.
Congratulations, your single is just exploding.
There is no bigger star in pop music than Britney Spears.
And I think that the music and the music videos, really, really helped spread that fast word about what a star Britney was. Not only was she beautiful, and not only was she a great singer, but her star power was so undeniable and she was so approachable that everyone was just immediately taken by her.
We love Britney!
It's like all of a sudden, you know, oh, it seems like overnight, just boom, you're just famous. It's weird.
Britney was not only approachable, but gracious and giving.
Sometimes I love
everyone wanted a piece of her.
I think
Sean Preston was born first. Jaden arrived a year after that. And Brittany embraced her new role of mum.
I mean, at that time, you know, I think she showed them love. She, you know, as a mom and when they were babies and when we were together. I mean, that it was, that everything was about the boys.
All right, so this is my oldest son, Caleb. This is my youngest son, Jaden.
What's up?
What's up, guys?
What's up, man?
Kevin Federline prides himself on always putting his family first.
How do you think I've done as a father?
You just wanted us to have fun as a family, you know? Yeah. And I appreciate that a lot. And, like, you took your time to do that.
When it comes to their mum, Kevin says he has never shied away from difficult questions from his boys.
They've had a lot of questions about it. I don't know that I can answer all of them for them, you know, but I just try to explain to them that your mom needed help, you know, and the people were in play to try to make that happen, to make it better, really to try to manage a situation that's just been really, really hectic.
For Kevin Federline, that also means making his own peace with Britney's father. In 2019, he was granted a 3-year restraining order against Jamie Spears after a physical altercation involving his then 13-year-old son, Preston.
Without getting into too many details about it, I mean, just boundaries were overstepped at a time where so much was going on that, I mean, it was kind of the last straw for me. I can't wait until the restraining order is over. because I'm gonna call him. You know, I know he feels horrible for what had happened, and I know my boys have forgiven him. People make mistakes, you know. I feel bad for him.
Silenced for all those years, it's only recently that Brittany has revealed the true extent of her suffering and the anger she feels towards her family.
My heart would just want to stand up in my family's faces and scream and cry and throw a tantrum and go back in time and do exactly what I wanted to do at those times. Yeah, and might even spit in their fucking faces. Why? Because the pain my family gave me, sitting me there all day and not being able to use my feet, as they watch their grandchildren run bases to base in a family neighborhood, as if I'm dead or I don't exist, honestly makes me look up and say, how the fuck did they get away with it?
By Jamie stepping in as conservator, nobody else was willing to do it. I feel like Jamie Spears really helped that situation at first a lot. I don't know if he overstayed or, you know, who knows. Obviously, things have happened over the past so-and-so years that, but in the beginning, he got everything back on track.
So you feel Jamie might have saved his daughter?
100%, I feel like he saved her back then.
Old and free at last, Brittany has had a lot of life to catch up on. Top of her to-do list was marrying longtime boyfriend Sam Asghari. But highlighting the deep divisions in her family, none of Brittany's closest relatives were at the wedding, not even her two boys. Her youngest son, Jaden, believes it was for the best.
At the time, like, it just wasn't a good time to go. And I mean, I'm not saying, like, I'm not happy for her. I'm really happy for them. But, like, I mean, she didn't invite her whole family. And then if it was just going to be me and Preston, like, I just don't see how that situation would have, like, ended on, you know, good terms.
The end of the conservatorship and Brittany's efforts to reclaim her life have, inevitably, led to questions about her taking more control of her relationship with her sons. She used to share the boys 50-50 with Kevin, but a few years ago, their co-parenting hit trouble. Kevin says it was because Sean Preston and Jaden weren't always happy living at their mum's home, so they moved in with him full-time.
Yeah, so the boys have decided that, you know, they're not seeing her right now. It's been a few months since they've actually even seen her.
It's not like she did anything bad or like anything like that. It's just the type of environment that she gave us was just not very comfortable for me and my brothers.
Fueling tensions are Brittany's frequent social media posts. For so long at the whims of the paparazzi, these days, for the most part, it's Brittany who controls what the public sees and hears of her. Sometimes taking her newfound freedom further than her boys would like.
You know, they kind of brush it off and they try to give her the benefit of the doubt, you know. But at the same time, I can tell that sometimes, you know, that hurts to be in that position. And I try to explain to him, like, you know, look, that's maybe just another way that she tries to express herself. But it doesn't take away from the fact that what it does to them, you know, it's tough.
For Brittany, the breakdown of the relationship with her sons is heartbreaking.
Since they've been gone, I've honestly felt like a huge part of me has died. Like, literally, I have no purpose anymore. They were my joy. They were my everything.
I look forward to seeing them. That was what I lived for. And then all of a sudden, they were gone.
Jaden hopes that one day both mom and sons can get their relationship back where it needs to be.
I know this has gone on for years and years and years, and there's a high chance that this is never going to really stop. But I'm hoping, like, for me, maybe she will, you know, just be chill with everybody and stop, like, you know, accusing, like, this person for that or this and that and hating this person. I just want her to get better mentally, and maybe, like, when she gets better, I really want to see her again, because I know that'll make me happy, it'll make Preston happy, just being together, you know?
In this fractured and feuding family, there's plenty of healing required on all sides.
Everybody in the situation needs to take a step back and realize that everybody is willing to forgive everybody, you know? That's what needs to be realized on all parts. You know what I'm saying? In the aspect of being able to move forward, you have to be able to apologize and forgive. Forgive yourself and forgive others. And I mean, that to me, in my head, literally is the only way forward. Boys want everybody to get along.
Yeah.
And if everybody really is wanting what the boys want, that's what needs to happen.
Yeah. The children are the most important thing. And somehow everybody has forgot that.
I know, we should have done that.
Right now though, Kevin Federline and his wife Victoria Prince say their priority is keeping home life as stable as possible and trying to ignore the circus that surrounds their private lives.
I want my sons to have the closest thing to a normal life that they can possibly have, because it'll make them better people.
Can they have normal life?
I think it's possible. They see me, so they know that if they really want to get away, they know how to get away.
The truth is, when your mother is one of the most famous faces in the world, a normal life is probably too much to expect. But there's no doubt both of Sean Preston and Jaden's parents only want the very best for their boys.
Now, if instead of me, Brittany was sitting here, what would you tell her?
I don't know. It's really... one of the toughest questions, you know. I try to think about that question because there's so many mixed emotion in there, you know. The father in me, the ex-husband, you know, it's hard to like tie it all together because I would want to apologize and then give advice and then ask if there's any way I can help.
This is a story about a girl named Lucky.
Isn't she lovely, this Hollywood girl?
It's really amazing that Brittany has survived this, and people should be looking at her as a champ. They should be looking at her as, like, surviving the Titanic, like a miracle. I look at her and I see someone who has so much goodness and so much sweetness and is so misunderstood. And I just want her to show the world how truly good of a person she really is.
If you're a weird introvert, oddball like me, who feels alone a lot of the time, and you needed to hear a story like this today so you don't feel alone, know this, my life has been far from easy, and you're not alone. Mm-hmm.